Web development is the work involved when developing a website, as the name suggests. It refers to all the actions required to build, maintain, and manage a website. There are three types of web development: front-end, back-end, and full-stack. Front-end development refers to everything that users will see and interact with, otherwise known as the client-facing side of the website, app, or digital product. Front-end developers are responsible for transforming design ideas into reality. To do that, they will use their understanding of HTML, CSS, and sometimes JavaScript, among a few other frameworks. Back-end development refers to everything that happens behind the scenes that ensures a site functions the way it's supposed to. Back-end developers are therefore responsible for creating a website's basic framework, including database interactions, user authentication, server, network, and hosting configuration, and business logic. To do that, they'll use their knowledge of server-side programming languages to their advantage, which includes PHP, Ruby, and Python, as they use tools like MySQL, Oracle, and Git. Full-stack development combines both front- and back-end development, so developers need to be aware of both and understand a wide variety of programming languages. Because they encompass so much knowledge from both front-end and back-end development, full-stack developers are usually given more of a leadership role on projects. The first step in the web development process is to acquire a domain name, which is the unique URL a user will type into a browser window to get to your website. Because you can only get one that someone isn't already using, you want to do this step first to get the domain name you want before someone else claims it. But another reason to acquire the domain name first is because the name of your domain will greatly impact the overall design of the site. Then it's time to come up with a plan. It'll generally start with a meeting with the client to figure out what they need for their site. That is, if you're creating a site for a client and not yourself. From there, you can determine the website's purpose and goals, which will help inform the kinds of content that will be on the site and how it'll be arranged. But ultimately, the site's purpose and goals should align with what the client needs for the site. Next, you'll create a mockup along with a wireframe and sitemap. A wireframe is like a two-dimensional skeletal outline of a web page or app, and the sitemap lists files on your site that'll help search engines like Google crawl and index your site's content. The mockup will be a better representation of how the finished site will look, and the prototype focuses more on functionality and gives you and your potential client a better idea of what the final version will look like and function. Keep in mind that the end users of this site will be the client's future customers, so it's important to make sure the site isn't just well designed, but easy to navigate as well. That way, it'll decrease the chances users will encounter any friction that would lead them to bounce off the site. The next step is researching your client's audience. Learning more about who this website is meant for will give you, as the developer, a better idea of the content that will be on the page, and that, in turn, will help inform how the site will look. While the web designer can take some creative liberties, the site's overall design should not only appeal to the client's audience, but hopefully encourage them to take whatever action the client wants them to take, whether it's staying on the site longer or converting them into a paid customer. After the overarching planning steps, it's time to start turning those plans into reality by building the back end of your website. Back-end developers will start with the homepage and develop a shell for the other pages, which is like a template for front-end developers to fill in with content. Other back-end developer tasks also include adding functional elements like contact forms and shopping carts to the site and making sure they work the way they're supposed to. Then it's time to build the front-end of your website, which includes some basic coding using HTML and CSS. And depending on the complexity of your design, you may also have to use some JavaScript to add more advanced functionality to the site. Then it's time for testing, which will ensure that everything works the way it's supposed to. For example, you don't want a user coming to your site and clicking on a link just to realize it doesn't work. Additionally, you want to make sure that the website doesn't look drastically different from browser to browser. Once the site goes live, you can better optimize your site by testing out different site titles and description combinations to see what works best in search engine results. Then you're ready to launch your site. Getting people to see it is then up to your marketing team, which would be the next step in the web development process. If it's your site, you may have a marketing team in-house. Outsource that work to an outside agency like PSB Inc., or market the site yourself. If it's your client's site, they may have their own marketing team to promote their site or use a marketing agency to do so. As a web developer, while your team generally doesn't involve a lot of marketing work, it is important to realize that your site you and your team built and the marketing work it'll take to promote it are intrinsically intertwined. The team's promotional efforts are only as good as the site and whatever products, services, or content you're trying to sell. Lastly, depending on your level of involvement, your web development duties may also include monitoring the site. This means checking website traffic to see how the site performs, adjusting content to better optimize the site for search engines, and updating content as needed as time goes on. The web development process isn't always a particularly easy one, and different developers have different approaches to it. But the goal is the same: create a visually appealing and user-friendly website and generate traffic towards that site. For non-developers, using a content management system, or CMS, may be ideal as it lets anyone create a site easily without any prior coding knowledge. But for users that need more robust and unique features, that's where custom development and custom design come in. PSP Inc. has decades of experience developing and designing custom websites for small businesses, helping them grow their business online. We can even work with a site you may already have and find out-of-the-box solutions for the problems your business site may be facing. Just reach out for a free consultation and we can work together to figure out the right solution for you and your business. To learn more about our custom web development, custom web design, or even our marketing services, head over to PSPinc.com.